kind of home are we looking for?
Definitely something in Worcester.
So it's Worcester?
It's spelled
Worcester.
It really ends, it's W-O-O-S-T-A-H, Worcester.
Worcester. All right, I'm fully educated.
So we really want to stay in Worcester.
Okay.
Kind of the best part about New England is that charm in their houses. So kind of looking for that old historic detail.
Cool.
Four bedrooms.
Okay.
An office, multiple bathrooms.
Multiple meaning at least two?
At least two.
Okay.
We do have a dog, so we definitely need a fenced-in yard.
So what is your price range?
You know, like $400,000. Okay. I think we could push a little, like 10 to 20.
Okay, I'll be very respectful of that.
Okay.
I have enough to go off of. I love the houses here. I definitely am really excited to get you and John into a fabulous dream home.
Yeah.
It'll be really fun. What I love about Massachusetts in general is that visually, aesthetically, it's amazing. There's tons of hills and rolling moments. It is the most Americana place in my mind. And I just love that Laura and John want to buy their dream home here in Worcester. This city invented the Valentine's card. OMG, the romance. And you know what? I think they might just fall in love with Salisbury Colonial. It's in a historic neighborhood close to great schools with plenty of green space. This is a beautiful house. I'm dying to see what they think of it. Well, hello, darling.
Hi.
And look at you.
Hi, David.
How are you?
How are you?
Oh, my gosh. Nice to meet you.
You too.
Congratulations on winning $1 million.
Thank you.
What was it like when you first scratched off that ticket?
I didn't even know what to do. I ran behind the counter and I hugged the cashier, and her husband walked in, thought I was robbing the place. I was like, oh, no, look, I won.
What do you guys think of this house?
So cute. I love the colonial style.
Good.
A little busy of a street.
It's a little bit
busy.
It's a little busy, but
it's kind of what you get for being in the city.
It is. So let me tell you a little bit about Salisbury Colonial.
Okay.
It's got four bedrooms, okay, 2.5 bathrooms. It has 2,111 square feet. We're at the tippy top of your price range. That's
okay.
$415,000.
Okay.
Let's go look at the house, shall
okay.
we?
Do it.
Here we go, guys.
Okay.
Come on in.
Oh, ooh. Wow.
All right.
I like it. It's bright.
I like it.
Tons of charm.
Yeah.
Take you through here. Here's the family room.
And here's... I really like the fireplace.
The fireplace is
great.
Really nice.
It just sets
good
the tone.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys good holiday people?
I'm a decorator.
Okay, she's definitely the decorator.
I can see some stockings going there.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. So before we get to the kitchen, I want to show you this little extra room, which is super cute.
Okay.
This could be great for your office, little sitting area.
Yes. Ooh. This is exactly what I wanted.
Perfect. But here we have the kitchen.
Wow.
This is wow.
This is nice.
This is definitely an upgrade from ours.
Yes.
Perfect. Good.
An island's a bonus. I didn't even ask for that.
No, you
I still
did.
Got it.
You did. You're welcome.
Thank you.
And of course, we have that beautiful dining room, which is fantastic.
Yes.
Are you dining room people?
We're yes. dining room people.
We
eat
people.
At our table every night.
That's fantastic.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Kids. I'm ready for you guys to have children.
This place comes with a backyard big enough to entertain friends and family.
Oh, wow. This is nice.
Wow, that's cute.
It is.
This is
yeah. It's nice.
Perfect.
It's already fenced in. Yeah.
You don't really have to do anything to it except maintain it.
Really, absolutely. We'll move in ready.
It is. All right. So before we get ahead of ourselves,
okay,
we obviously have to check out the bedrooms upstairs.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
The first floor bathroom is nicely finished with white subway tiles. But typical for a house built in the 30s, all the upstairs rooms, including the master, are, well, just...
a little on the smaller side.
It
yeah,
is.
I agree. A little on the smaller side.
But the great thing about this older home is it comes with an ensuite, which
ooh,
is very
ooh,
rare for an older house.
Okay.
But you guys
like
check
that
out the master bath.
Okay.
Let me go first.
Yes.
You'll love it.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
This is definitely an added bonus.
Yeah, it's kind of a good trade-off for a smaller bedroom.
Absolutely. We don't have our own bathroom now, so this is...
this works. We don't have to fight over a sink.
All right, come on up. So obviously they finished the attic.
How did you even know I wanted the bonus room?
Welcome to the bonus room.
We could use this as a breakout space.
Right.
You know.
This is a great space.
Cool. How'd you guys like the house?
I liked it a lot.
I loved it.
Yeah.
Good. Are you ready to spend some money?
Oh, yeah.
All right. After you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I have to say, I've really enjoyed getting to know Worcester. Did I do it right?
Yes,
I am a native now. It's a beautiful place, super unique, and I love all of the colonial old homes here. I get why you guys are obsessed. Mm-hmm. But let's talk about the houses. Okay. Salisbury Colonial, super cute house, so expensive. It has to cover every single thing that you guys want, and then some for Agreed. You to kind of stretch that far.
So. Yeah, I loved it. I mean, it was on a busy road. Yeah. Which could look past. The inside was beautiful.
You know, it did have the smaller master bedroom, but it had that amazing ensuite, which really sold it. Yeah.
Then your request was, let's get that house, that same aesthetic, the older home, but at a much more inexpensive price tag. So yeah. I brought you over to Newton Hill.
Very cute house. It was on the busier street again, but the price point was really appealing for us. I actually liked the craftsman look. It did have that wow sense when you went into the living room with the coffered ceilings. You know, the backyard wasn't a favorite for me.
No, but it did have a lot of party space. Hot tub, pool.
It did. You're right.
And that's one thing that Salisbury Colonial did not have.
It did not.
So you really just wanted a quieter street to look on.
Right.
So I took you over to Winter Heights.
We were both pleasantly surprised by that. The square footage in that house left nothing to be desired. There was so much storage.
It did need a few updates.
Yes.
You know, it was definitely looking very 1980s. You would have to put in probably about $15,000 to $20,000 to get it to that look that you guys really want to.
It did have the fenced-in yard, and it did have the deck, which we didn't know we wanted.
Right.
So, again, lots of bonuses to that.
Interesting. I can't tell which house you guys are leaning towards. Very confused.
I don't know.
This is a tough choice.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I'm leaning more towards the Salisbury Colonial.
Me too.
It still had that old charm that I know you guys were looking for.
Yeah.
But you don't have to do anything to it. It just had so many great moments.
So it really just has everything that we were looking for. There's a reason to go up that $15,000. And it was in our desired neighborhood. That was a huge selling point for us. And even though the street was a little bit busier, it's still walkable. You know, we can still go down with our baby strollers and...
She said it.
She just said it.
I didn't have to coax her. Get to work.